Out of all superheroes, everyone has their favorite. Some people say it's the Flash. Others say it's Wonder Woman, Superman, or the Hulk. But there's no dispute for Mitchell Joseph. It's definitely Batman.
He loves the Batman movies.
All-time favorite is Batman.
Batman? He loves Batman.
Started out as Batman and still is Batman today.
If Batman is ever coming to the JCC or any other place that's local, we'll get Mitchell outside of the house and we'll have him go interact with Batman because he loves Batman.
Mitchell Joseph, who's 25 years old, is a huge Batman fan. He has an enormous array of Batman movies, collectible items, and clothes. Batman gives Mitchell an ability to live a full life of adventure and excitement. What many people don't know is that Mitchell was born with a Jewish genetic disease called familial dysautonomia, or FD. Familial, which is genetic through the family, and dysautonomia is the dysfunction of the autonomic and sensory nervous systems. This means that he cannot feel temperature or pain in his body. Mitchell's disorder has many symptoms, including scoliosis, unstable blood pressure, and the inability to produce tears.
He has a DVD player and he scrapes his hands on it a lot. And that's kind of when he's excited or when he's watching it continuously. And he rubs his knuckles on it and they get red. Sometimes he'll bang them and he gets like sores on his hands.
You know, Mitchell can bang his hand. One time he got it caught in the door, the sliding door of the van, inadvertently. And he didn't know anything happened really other than his hand was stuck.
We find a way to catch the signals that his body sent out to us. Like, for example, when he's cold, you can see like what we call a goose bump, and he's shivering. That's a sign that he's cold.
When Mitchell wakes up, his body needs to adjust from sleep to wake mode. Because his vital signs are not regulated, he often goes into a state called crisis. This causes him to have many episodes of retching, sneezing, high blood pressure, and heart rate.
He can retch almost like he needs to throw up, but he can't. He can't throw up. He had a thing called a fundoplication, which sews the top of the stomach. So he can't throw up. We have to vent anything that's there in order to bring it out. So he can retch, but he can't throw up.
You really have to watch Mitchell and make sure that he doesn't aspirate or have an accident. And it can be very scary at times when he gets sick or when he goes into crisis.
When something goes wrong, everyone chips in. Someone gets the oxygen, someone goes and helps him, and it's a whole effort by everyone.
Finding out that Mitchell had FD was really devastating. It was very difficult. And the last thing I expected was to have a baby that wasn't healthy. And it was really difficult because we were very scared, not knowing what was going to be for his future.
We had to learn what to do, what to deal with, what it really meant. How do we take care of them? All those things went through our heads.
Right.
Since Mitchell cannot swallow food from his mouth, he uses a feeding tube. Next to Mitchell's belly button, he has another button that is used for medication, hydration, and nutrition.
That's right.
His feeds is a puree and a formula. They're to like give him nutrients and to keep his body fed. Oh, he gets medications. He gets a lot of respiratory medications, which includes his inhalers and his neb treatments.
He gets what are the things that call carbidopa, so that help him with his blood pressure.
He gets formula that the doctor has prescribed called Complete Pediatric. He also gets Pedialyte and water, but we also Mom has always wanted him to eat food that his brother and sister eats as well. So when I make the feeds, there's scrambled eggs, there's peaches, sweet potatoes, carrots, avocados, peanut butter, and this powder called Scanda Shake, which adds a lot of calories to the food. What else?
In order to get to know him better, let's take a look at a day in the life of Mitchell. Around 6:30 a.m., Mitchell usually wakes up. With the help of either his mom or one of his nurses, together they walk downstairs. Then his morning routine begins with respiratory treatments, including a nebulizer medication, a cofalator, and vest treatment.
We start with breathing treatments and nebulizers, and then he has a vest treatment, and then he has a cofalator. All of these things help with trying to clear his system so that he doesn't aspirate into his lungs.
The vest that we put on is called an ABI vest. It shakes his chest. We used to do chest compressions where we used to go like this, whole cupping on his back to loosen secretions that are in his lungs.
One is to shake everything up basically so that when you go to do the cough later, he can cough, and if he has any secretions, he can bring them up.
He wears what's called a BiPAP, and it's a breathing machine that gives him oxygen if he needs it, just to keep his oxygen level up. A lot of times at night, some people will either skip a breath, not necessarily Mitchell, but their just breathing becomes more shallow when you sleep. And in order to keep his oxygenation at a certain level, that we put that on him at night.
Once Mitchell is up to date with his medicine and treatments, it's time to pack up and go to his 21 plus program. During the weekdays, Mitchell attends this program at Hollydale High School in Washington Township. Mitchell's mom and nurse help him get to the car safely. He loves to travel singing along with his favorite tunes. Mitchell's mom meets up with the bus driver at a designated bus stop, who takes Mitchell and his nurse to the daily program.
When he doesn't want to work, he does nothing. But usually you can persuade him. He will work on puzzles, matching shapes, matching patterns. He counts money. Activity-wise, he is now starting to ride a bike. It's a specialized bike where he can steer, but in the back there's a handle that you can help him steer.
At his program, Mitchell interacts with other students and teachers. He has developed a great support of friends.
When they take attendance, Mitchell takes attendance and he has to point to everybody, so he knows everybody's name. He finds it hard to make friends, but he's very compassionate to other kids that are in wheelchairs. It's strange. He knows that they need more help than he does at times because he's not wheelchair bound as much. So he also likes to help people that are in wheelchairs. He likes help pushing them. He likes touching their hands and asking them if they're okay. So he has his own way of having friendships.
Coming home from his program, it's time for his afternoon routine. He once again gets respiratory treatments.
So Mitchell loves the villains, like to every Disney movie and even to some other movies that he watches. Like he loves the Joker, he loves the Penguin, all from Batman. He loves all the Batman villains. He loves Shere Khan from The Jungle Book, Scar from The Lion King, Ursula from The Little Mermaid.
Thumbelina, so he loved that, and he watched SpongeBob also.
He loves Disney, he really loves villains, and other like things that aren't Disney, so like The Wizard of Oz, or Chitty Chitty Bang Bang.
When you speak the lines to him, you develop a bond that's like, I don't want to say it's unreal, but it's just, it's an interaction with Mitchell that you can't have with any other person.
definitely participating in his world and in those films. Mitchell loves that. So he loves when everyone sings his songs and really creates that like community with him.
Always get a hello, a smile. He's always happy singing. He likes to be read to at night, which I do. It's just amazing how happy this child is.
Mitchell has overcome many obstacles and has become a superhero himself. Every day he battles with FD and wins.
Mitchell has taught me to enjoy each day and to make the most of whatever you have. And I try to have fun. It's hard to be a caretaker and a mom. That's one of the most difficult things that goes with this for me. It's hard to just step back and be a mom because there's so many things that I have to look out for his well-being.
Mitchell's special because he has an infectious sense of humor and a laugh that, you look at him, and if he's feeling good, he's almost always in good spirits.
Even though he's sick a lot, he still like finds things in life to be happy about and sing, and he has compassion and wants the people around him to be happy and like share that with him.
What makes him unique is Mitchell. Mitchell is... First, he's taught me patience. Mitchell has a good soul. There's nothing bad in Mitchell. He hasn't been influenced by the world. We need to take a lesson on that.
He's helped me realize that these kids are special, but even though they are special, have special needs, they need to be treated like a normal child. They do something wrong, yes, they need to be corrected. But there are certain ways and to do this. But with Mitchell, you just have to say certain things and he follows through.
No matter how stressed I am sometimes, or if I'm in a really bad mood, he's always taught me how to look at the bright side of things. And he's also taught me how to interact with other special needs kids and make an impact in their life.
Advocating for Mitchell means that I am fighting for his rights, because Mitchell can't really speak for himself. And he deserves a quality of life that is as good as everyone else's. And he needs certain supplies, and he needs to go to certain doctors, and he needs different kinds of appointments. And all of those things need to be done. A lot of times it's a fight for the insurance company because they don't want to provide you with the best health care. They just want to give you the minimum services that they have to. So I speak up, and I don't like to quit, and I don't like to lose. So I keep finding a way.
Suddenly appear every time you are near. Just like me, they long to be close to you. Why do stars fall down from the sky every time you walk by? Just like me, they long to be close to you. On the day that you were born.
Mitchell, who is that?
Hey.
Oh, tell me.
Batman? Yes.
Taking a short video, Batman.
Yay!
Oh! Who is that?
Him. Come on.
My shirt.
That's right.
So how many times can we catch you today? When are you out?
Shake his hand.
So that means 2, 4, that whole thing.
Just like me, they love.
Thank you.
decided to create a dream.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mitchell. Happy birthday to you.
Close to you.